predict the pathway that our bomb rockets are going to take, okay? Because as Putin said, unless there's an unbalanced force that acts upon it, it's going to go on forever and ever and ever and ever. Do you think that's what's going to happen?
No.
Let's see. So, all right, here we go.
She's going to burn some hydrogen to make it blast off.
Right,
she's going to burn the same oxygen. Remember, we said there's different types of gas. She's going to burn some hydrogen.
Nice. Do you want to see that one more time?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, here we go. Let's do it one more time. Do another countdown. From 3, 2, 1.
Gravity.
Yeah, absolutely. Gravity. Well done, guys. So, gravity was pulled it back down, and that's how we have a parabolic curve, which is essentially what you saw. And to get a better idea of that, think of throwing a ball, right? You throw a ball without a lot of force, you're going to have a spore arc. It's not going to go so fast. If you have a really good throw, it might look something like that, or like that, even stronger. If you have such a good throw, you're going 28,000 kilometers per hour, and might go out into space, and then match the curvature of the Earth. What's the name of this?
Orbit.
Orbit, absolutely. It goes into orbit. But then our astronauts built their experiments
from
research. They need to
from
come back
space.
Out
we're
of the Earth, and
soon.
They need to go through that blue sheet there, which is?
The
atmosphere. So they're going really,
so
really, really fast,
line,
right?
The blue line above the Earth.
The
it's blue, that's the sky, which
we
see when we look up.
So it squashes the air.
Then it's black afterwards.
It's
a very thin sky.
The air explodes.
Call it the atmosphere.
Our astronauts are able to see this plasma fire outside through the little window in the capsule. And it can get kind of dangerous. Does anyone want to see something like that right here?
Yeah. When the astronauts come back through that blue line, it gets very hot because they're in space with nothing blocking them. And then they get a blue line that blocks them.
So, this is
going to show you how it
works. I have this clear tube inside. It's just a bit of normal cotton wool. Now, if I do this correctly, and I can't always get it right, it's a little tricky, you should see that cotton wool burst into flames. So I will squash the air, heating it up to about 500 degrees Celsius. You guys think I can do it? So much confidence in me. Thanks, guys. Awesome. All right, guys. Well, I'm going to try my best. I want you guys to pay very close attention to the bottom where my cotton wool is. You should see a small flame. All right. So let's give me a really big countdown, guys. From 3, 2, 1. Blast off. Did you see it?
Yeah.
Well, in case you didn't see it, here's also a video of it happening right now. We'll keep watching. So there you go.